സ്വപ്നങ്ങൾക്ക് പുറകെ പായുന്നവരെ കുറിച്ച് ആലങ്കാരികമായി സ്വപ്നച്ചിറകിൽ പറക്കുന്നവർ എന്നൊക്കെ നമ്മൾ പറയാറുണ്ട് പക്ഷെ എനി ഷീ മാറ്റേഴ്സിൽ അക്ഷരാർത്ഥത്തിൽ പറന്നുകൊണ്ട് സ്വപ്നങ്ങളെ പിന്തുടരുന്ന അതിലൂടെ ചരിത്രം സൃഷ്ടിക്കുന്നവരെ കുറിച്ചാണ് നമ്മൾ അറിയാൻ പോകുന്നത് Here we have with us Captain Zoya Agarwal, the captain of the all women pilot team, who made us all proud at the beginning of this week by flying over the North Pole. But that's just one small detail. They actually flew the longest commercial flight route Air India flies as of now, and it is one of the longest flight routes world over. So she's here to talk about her team and how they came together to achieve this dream and to inspire all of us. Very warm welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, everybody's talking about the North Pole. So let me start from there. Most of us cannot even hope to see North Pole, have a glance of that piece of land or ice ever in our lives. But you flew above and over it. What was the most cherished moment during that time?
So firstly and foremostly, never say never, because maybe on our next flight, when we are flying over the North Pole once again, doing one of these longest flights in the world, you may just be on board along with us. So firstly, never say never. That's something we should never ever do. And secondly, the challenges over North Pole are plenty, because right from the start of the commencement of the flight, we have to make sure that there are very stringent requirements that have to be taken care of, right from the equipment of the airplanes to the training of the crew, the pilots, the cabin crew. There are, for example, the North Pole, when you divert in the polar region, there are only a handful of the airports which are available for diversion, and the biggest challenge in all those airports being of the low temperatures. So all the temperatures are pretty much on an average 30 degrees below zero. So that's a real challenge in case of an actual diversion, when you have to step outside the airplane. You cannot just go outside wearing a jacket. You need something known as polar suits. So we need to have a couple of them on board. Each of them costs more than $5,000, and it weighs a whopping 32 pounds, which is almost 15 kilograms each. So you have to don that. It's got an adult bib and the big jacket and two set of gloves and mittens. And so it's pretty elaborate having to cut short. And this is also one of the lists of the equipments. And above all, once everything else has met the legalities and the clearances, you need to have the weather gods on your side. Because if you don't do your prayers properly, you're not going to have good weather to go polar.
How would a 10-year-old Zoya, not Captain Agarwal, a 10-year-old Zoya react to something so historic? What would she be doing right now?
So the 10-year-old Zoya, I still have that 8-year-old Zoya hidden inside of me, because that's the Zoya that pushes me and drives me to do more and go further and fly further in life. You know, I think that little girl always inspires me to go above and beyond, to chase my dreams even now. And I think that is the Zoya, or that is the child we all need to have inside of us for the rest of our lives, because that is the person that's going to strive you to do better and bigger things in life.
So a little bit about that Zoya of 8 years or 10 years. How was the runway of your life? The support system that helped you fly above every obstacle. So a little bit about your family.
So I am the only child of my parents, and I come from humble backgrounds, where I was taught to walk behind the shadows of my elders, and nowhere in that thought process was inculcated that Zoya should think that she should fly up in the skies for sure, because I'm from a very conservative background, and which is totally fine, because we all have a different tendency to think. When I was growing up, however, I always wanted to strive to do something more, and I used to sit on top of the terrace, and I was always very fond of stargazing. And I used to spot the constellations amongst the stars, you know, at 5 in the morning. I've been a night bird. Even I think back then, probably the little Zoya knew that she was going to join Air India and fly international back in those days. So, you know, my body kind of geared up early for the jet lag. So I used to sit on top of my terrace, look at those jumbo jets, the contrails, and I used to wonder, can I possibly fly one of those beautiful flying objects one day?
So coming back to this historic feat, you had a wonderful team of women pilots with you. How was your bonding? What was the strength of your team?
Oh, we were, I think we were stronger than any rock you can possibly find. You've heard of the Rock of Gibraltar, right? So probably we were that. And I'm so proud of my girls, Captain Tanmay Papagiri, Captain Akanksha Sunavane, Captain Shivani Manas. We were this dream team. We were the four Bharat ki betis, as I like to call us, and who flew one of the world's longest flights, Air India's longest flights, one of the flights which was trademarked as PM Modi ji's dream, because when he went to San Francisco, this was his vision to start the flight between the two Silicon Valleys of the US and India.
What would you like to tell those little girls, 8-year-olds, 10-year-olds, and even boys technically, who believe that they might not have it in them to get to their dreams? What would your message be?
So I go to a lot of schools and I try and motivate young girls, young children alike, you know. I always feel that I have faced so many challenges in my life, and in spite of that, I have come here. Here I am, live example in front of you of what you can dream and what you can achieve. All you have to do is set your mind to it and work towards it tirelessly. There is no world called impossible, because every single reality, the amazing reality, begins with a great dream, and every amazing dream begins with a great dreamer. And that dreamer is you. All you have to do is set your mind to it, work towards it, look at your dream straight in the eye, and go and achieve it. Just do it, believe in yourself, and the world's your oyster.
Thank you so much for those strong, powerful, and inspiring words, ma'am. Hope to talk to you again about some other historic event that you command from the forefront. Thank you so much.
Looking forward, Roshni. Thank you for having me.